So, it's June 1997. The Spice Girls still roam the charts. Three brothers have invented the audio lobotomy. Nick Cage's face is everywhere. And there's a new Batman.
All right, everyone. Chill.
You're in desperate need of a new video game. How about Game Paradise? Let's do a flashback review. Hey, and welcome to the first flashback review, where we are going to have a flashback to 1997 to look at Game Tengoku, or better known in the West, The Game Paradise. We're going to see how it fared at the time of its release, and if it actually holds out today. Before we look at the game, let's see what we're playing at the time. Well, if you're a PlayStation owner, you were definitely spoiled. Final Fantasy VII was the big seller of the day, and Castlevania Symphony of the Night had been just released. Me, personally, I picked up an N64 and I was playing Mario 64 and Mario Kart, and Doom 64, which I really loved. I don't know about you, but I was really influenced with what was going on in the arcades at the time. Dodonpachi would have been about 4 months old, but not that I saw it in the arcade, because in 1997 it was all about the fighters. Well, Namco had Tekken 3, and Sega brought out Virtua Fighter 3. Capcom, of course, brought out a nice bit of new kit, the CPS3, and brought out Street Fighter 3, the new generation. And they also brought out Vampire Savior 1 and 2, which were extremely popular at the time, especially in Japan. Let's not forget about good old SNK. They just put out Real Bout Fatal Fury Special. And Samurai Shodown 4 would have been still very popular in the arcades at that time. So I've scraped up a little bit of cash and I'm in the market for a video game. But would I buy The Game Paradise? Let's take a look at the game. Game Paradise is a vertical shoot 'em up, or more specifically a cute 'em up. Originally released in the arcades by Jellico on their Mega System 32 hardware, which looks suspiciously like a Taito F3 system, but apparently it's more Mega. They actually had a few good games on it, like P47 Aces, which got ported to the PC Engine, Tetris, which it ended up on the Saturn, and Gratia Second Earth, which I don't think got a port. While it did go under the radar in the West, it did generally get a warm reception in Japan, and the PCB is relatively common, so it must have been in a lot of Japanese arcades back in the day. It was of course ported to the Sega Saturn, and in 1997 it was released in Japan only at the retail price of 5,800 yen, which would have been about $50 at the time. So Jellico must have seen what Konami did and decided, let's go all Parodius on our legacy franchise. While it might have been a good idea from a Japanese-centric perspective, in my opinion the source material was far too obscure, certainly for the West, with only City Connection and possibly Plus Alpha being familiar to Western audience. But unlike the pure wackiness of Parodius, Game Paradise has a cool little backstory to pull the characters together and provides quite interesting themes for the different stages. Of course, we get our textbook Japanese-style bad guy, genius Francois Yamada, who's taken over the arcades and brought them to life. And we get to choose from one of our favourite Jellico classic arcade characters to shoot up the arcade and to defeat our borderline pervert bad guy who doesn't seem to wear pants under his lab coat. This is classic Japanese parody stuff. Just absolutely love this arcade theme. We get to fight actual arcade machines, pinball tables, UFO catches, and the cute little prizes. There's lots of fan service giving homage to the classics such as Space Invaders and Arkanoid. And there's definitely a nod to Sega, with a stage that is shooting Daytona-style cars, and there is Afterburner references going on there too. For gameplay, Jerko gave us a very simple power-up mechanism. You've got your standard smart bombs, and you've also got a pair of options which are easily picked out throughout the game. These options are actually mini main characters with similar powers to their full-size versions. They also gave us a standard hold-down power shot, a la Blazing Star. For scoring, it's all about collecting those aubergines, which actually increase in value if picked up sequentially within a certain period of time. As you can imagine, the game is a simple shooter, with very little depth, but that's not what you expect from this kind of game. What's important is that it plays well and it's extremely fun. There's very little slowdown and visually it's gorgeous, with bright and colourful detailed sprites. What can I say? This game is pure wacky nostalgic fun. I've got to say, it's been really well ported, but like other vertical shooters that are set to horizontal mode, it does suffer from lack of space to manoeuvre, and enemy patterns have been slightly adjusted to compensate. Luckily, from what I saw from the vertical mode, it does look a lot better and closer to the arcade. And I have to say, the arcade does run a bit quicker and has extra background scaling. But these kind of changes are expected and not a deal breaker. I did include some arcade footage for comparison. Luckily, the fine folks at Joko had added an arrange mode. This gives much life back into the game, adding some cutscenes, extra dialogue, and more importantly, extra levels. But in 1997, if I knew about this game, was it worth getting? Let's be honest, Game Paradise would really struggle to get my attention back in the day. Granted, Joko were not particularly targeting my demographic, especially since it wasn't even released in my region. But that never stopped me from getting imports. In fact, I very rarely bought a PAL game ever since I first started importing with the Mega Drive. Back then, before Tinternet, it really was the dark ages when it came to getting game info or reviews, especially for imports. Unfortunately, I was also beyond the age to beg my parents to buy me a video game mag. My funds were too precious and I was too tired to buy a magazine. I needed the money for the actual video game itself. So getting a new game really came down to four key factors. Word of mouth. Well, my mates would not have known about this game. Developer track record. Yeah, I did know Jellico from the arcades, but as far as I'm concerned, they weren't a big player. Was it in the actual arcades? Well, no, I never saw it. And then the big one, the box art. Now this is where it would have been make or break for me. And looking at the cover, no way I would have spent my hard-earned cash on it. I mean, yes, it's wacky and colourful, but I wouldn't have known it's a shooter. I had actually bought Twin B on the SNES a few years prior, and I love Parodius, so I wasn't afraid or put off by the Japanese cuteness of it, but this wouldn't have stuck out for me. Like I mentioned before, around this time I would have been playing heaps of Doom 64 and Mario Kart. In fact, it's around this time I was picking up Mace the Dark Ages, and I was actually convincing my friends that it was a very good fighter. It was obvious at the time I was in need for a good game, and I was always in the market for a good shooter. But if I had a Saturn, my god, there was some competition for Game Paradise. Because Tenersoft were producing some pure magic with Thunder Force 5 and Blastwing. Let's not forget about those amazing STV ports like Shinryu and Terra Driver. They were absolute belters. Unfortunately for 1997, I have to say it wouldn't been worth picking up at the time. Purely from the fact that there's so many better shooters out there, especially for the Saturn. But for today's market, is it worth picking up? The simple answer is yes. Absolutely. The competition that put it in the shade in 1997 have all shot up sky high in price, allowing its time to bask in the sun. In today's market, you could probably pick it up for about 4,500 yen, which is 35 to 40 US or about £30. So that's a lot of fun for your money. And also, like a good vintage, it's aged really well over the years, and now it's absolutely oozing nostalgia. So much, even got a remix for the PS4. It's instant pick up and play, wacky nostalgic fun, and who doesn't want a bit of that? Well, if you made it to the end of the video, thank you very much. It was a lot of fun to put together, and I thought it was about time I gave something back to the community after lurking so long, even if it was completely amateur hour, but I might make some more stuff if I can be asked. Let's see. Before I go, just a quick shout out and a thank you to KidShoryuken. He is the man, he knows his stuff. If you don't know him already, he does some Japanese game imports, has some great videos. If I learn how to do this linking and all the rest of it, I will put the link into the video. And of course, a big shout out and thank you to the Sarah Crew fam, as always. I will be seeing you guys, and laters.